Assalamu alaikum. Does Islam teach to kill apostate? Let us see what is the stand of Islam regarding the freedom of faith. Allah says in Surah Baqarah, Surah number 2, ayat number 256, like raha fi deen. There is no compulsion in religion or no compulsion in deen. You cannot force anyone to become Muslim. If you say that death should be awarded to apostates, then it means you are forcing him not to leave Islam. You are threatening him with death if he or she leaves Islam. A person who leaves his faith or religion is called as an apostate. Allah says in Surah Al-Kahf, Surah number 18, ayat number 29, say the truth is from your Lord. Let him who wills believe it and let him who wills reject it. So in this ayah, Allah is giving the freedom of faith to everyone. A person has a choice whether he wants to accept Islam or reject Islam. In Surah Yunus, Surah number 10, ayat number 99, Allah says, if it had been your Lord's will, they all would have believed, all who are on the earth. Will you then compel the people against their will to believe? In this ayah, Allah is saying that it was not the mashiyat of Allah that everyone on the earth would have believed in Islam. The simple reason is, we have free will. We have freedom to accept Islam or to reject Islam. It is illogical to force someone to believe or enter Islam. Neither physical nor psychological force can be applied on anyone to believe in Islam. Faith comes from inner conviction and not from external compulsion. Coming to the topic, does Quran mentions about apostasy? Yes, several times. What punishment it prescribes? No worldly punishment for sure. It always speak about punishment in the life hereafter. Quran addresses the issue of apostasy at several places. Almighty God tells about the people leaving Islam, but at not a single place God says that such people should be killed. Look at Surah Baqarah, Surah number 2, ayat number 217. Similarly, Surah Al Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 86 to 90, Surah Nisa, Surah number 4, ayat number 137, Surah Tawbah, Surah number 9, ayat number 66-74. Surah Nahl, Surah number 16, ayat number 106 to 109, and Surah Muhammad, Surah number 47, ayat number 25 to 27. All these ayah talk about apostasy, but nowhere Allah prescribe any worldly punishment for apostasy. For example, Surah Baqarah, ayat number 217 says, and if anyone among you turns back from his religion and dies as a disbeliever, then the works of such as these will be lost in this life, and in the hereafter, they will be the dwellers of the fire, abiding therein forever. So you see that here also Allah talks about apostasy, but Allah did not say that such people should be killed. All the ayah that I referred, you can go through those ayah. Nowhere you will find Allah prescribing any punishment for apostasy. Let us look at Surah Nisa, Surah number 4, ayat number 137. Ayah says, surely those who believe, then disbelieve, then believe, and disbelieve and go on increasing in disbelief, God will not forgive them nor guide them. Now please note, this ayah talks about an apostate coming back to Islam and then again becoming apostate. If you kill apostate, then how he will get chance to again come to Islam? So this ayah directly contradicts with death for apostasy. So similarly, you can go through all the ayah that I quoted. Now the important point to be noted is, Quran gives absolute freedom of belief or disbelief. None can be forced to believe in Islam. None can be threatened with death for leaving Islam. Quran mentions about apostasy issue several times, but not a single time Allah says that apostate should be killed. Please mind it. Almost every place Almighty God talks about punishment in the life hereafter. The biggest irony is that almost all ayah that deal with apostasy were revealed in Medina, where Islamic state was established. Imagine, even Surah Tawbah, which was revealed during wartime, speaks about apostasy but stops short of execution of apostates. In Medina, Islamic State was established and criminal laws were implemented. In this situation, what big deal it was to reveal that apostates should be killed? What difficult it was to say in such place that punishment for apostasy is capital punishment? But no, Quran never said so. Any unbiased Muslim or non-Muslim, after going through all ayah that talk about apostasy, will agree that Quran does not prescribe death penalty for apostasy. In fact, death for apostasy directly contradicts with several ayah of the Quran. Surah Baqarah ayat number 256, Surah Ali Imran ayat number 90, and Surah Nisa ayat number 137. One important thing to understand is that Quran clearly says in Surah Maidah, Surah number 5 ayat number 32, that capital punishment can be given to anyone only in two situations. Situation 1, if person has killed someone innocent, and situation 2, if someone is spreading mischief in the land, if he is causing the fasad fill earth. Now, it will be up to the Islamic State ruler to decide whether a particular case of apostasy can be termed as fasad fill earth. This term fasad or spreading mischief on land is abstract term, and its implementation will vary from time to time and case to case. So, if any particular case of apostasy falls under this category, then that person can be given capital punishment. Now, important point to note is that the death punishment will be because of spreading mischief in land and not because of only apostasy. So, the ayah that I quoted make very clear that in Islam, there is no worldly punishment for apostasy. All the punishment is for the life hereafter. But we know today that most of the Muslims have abandoned Quran. Most of the Muslims have failed to make Quran as the final criteria. Most of the Muslims do not consider Quran to be their final criteria. Now, what does Quran say on this topic? Quran says that one must judge as per the revelation of Almighty God. Allah says in Surah Maidah, Surah number 5, ayat number 44, فَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمِ الْكَافِرُونَ, that if anyone fails to judge by what Allah has revealed, then definitely they are kafir. So Allah is saying that those people are kafir who do not judge by what Allah has revealed. That is the Quran. Similarly, in ayat number 45, Allah says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ, those who do not judge by what Allah has revealed, they are zalim. And ayat number 47, Allah says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ, those who do not judge by what Allah has revealed, they are fasiq. So Allah is saying that if you don't make Quran as your hakam, then you are kafir, then you are fasiq, then you are zalim. Now on the apostasy, Allah has made things very, very clear. Now it is up to an individual to believe in what Quran has said or go against what Quran has said. Assalamu alaikum.